pair of shoes might cost 0.002 Bitcoin. On Amazon, the tech and e-commerce giant has posted a job listing for a digital currency and blockchain product lead, aka somebody who really understands crypto. According to these reports, Amazon might be looking to accept Bitcoin or maybe launch its own cryptocurrency for payment as soon as next year. The company is denying this rumor, but does say of cryptocurrencies, quote, "We remain focused on exploring what this could look like for customers shopping on Amazon," end quote. Meanwhile, Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey said Bitcoin could be a big part of his business in the future as well. So if heavyweights like Amazon and Twitter jump in, does that mean crypto is back in action, party people? I hope so. Joining me to discuss, venture capitalist and Bitcoin Foundation chairman Brock Pierce. Brock, you know this game better than anyone. Look at your hat, for God's sake. It's fantastic. So tell me, what does Amazon's exploration of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrency do to our world? How does it benefit me?
Well, I mean, it's a signal that we've seen many times. This is not new. We watched first academia's interest, venture capital's interest, and then acceptance. And then we saw it in the big tech and Amazon being one of those. And then we saw it in the financial services and banking sector, and now governments. Yet again, this is another step forward for the industry. And ultimately, cryptocurrency does have pulling it out and under. September 7th, every merchant in El Salvador has to accept Bitcoin for all goods and services, with some exceptions, but generally that's the case. And so I think it's a great thing. It's unclear whether Amazon will actually implement this, but glad to see them continuing to focus on innovation and how we can improve the experiences for customers.
And Twitter's been there for quite a while. Jack Dorsey, he certainly has had early interest in Bitcoin for some time. His side company, Square, utilizes Bitcoin. So if you've got Twitter and Amazon both here, does that somehow stabilize the market, and is that necessary?
Well, I think it grows the market. I'm not sure it's a lot for Bitcoin. And to his credit, glad to see him continuing to be a pioneer, mm-hmm. helping to propel and push society forward to create a more equitable world. Remember, 4 to 4.5 billion people on the planet are on or underbanked. They lack financial services. Mm-hmm. These technologies are going to create, you know, financial inclusion, ubiquitous inclusion for everyone, you know, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And I think this is essential for everyone.
All right.
To pursue that happiness that is the American dream.
It is the American dream, and hopefully it's something that will take El Salvador out of, you know, the economic gutter that its neighbors have been embroiled in for so long because of the drug war. Most people, a vast majority of people in El Salvador, they use cash. They don't have bank accounts. Everything is done via cash. How do they switch from that to Bitcoin and, you know, raise their mobility in life as well?
Well, it'll be Bitcoin as well as effectively a digital dollar, but 70% of the population of El Salvador is unbanked. They don't have banks, they don't have credit cards. If you order an Uber in El Salvador, you get to your destination, you pay with cash. It's a cash-based economy. And a cash-based economy is lacking in credit facilities and a lot of the things that have enabled us as Americans to have such wonderful lives. So I think this is an incredible thing. I led a delegation down, the first formal delegation to visit El Salvador since COVID, to meet with the various ministers, and I commend everything that government is doing. I think it's great. They're truly attempting to serve the people in a very entrepreneurial fashion.
I think it's fantastic, and they have good surf breaks. I hope they clean everything up there, so El Salvador becomes a real destination, and it's all possibly because of crypto. Brock, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me again.
And always, hats off to your haberdasher.